Welcome to a Realvolve overview. This is Mark Stepp. I want to take you through a quick overview of what Realvolve is, some of the features and functionality, some exciting things that Realvolve has to offer. On the main screen of Realvolve is your main desktop. On the left-hand side is the list view. It has many of the search features that you'd like to see in software. It gives you the ability to search for any keyword. Typing it in, it immediately searches all the different sections of the software very quickly and easily. So anytime that the word main is in anything, it will allow you to quickly pull them up, either by contact, by property, transaction, any documents, tags, or appointments. Without the search, gives you the complete list of all the contacts in your database, all the properties, transactions, documents, and tag items that are in your list. Now I'm just going to go over here to the contacts area, and you can see it quickly shows all the contacts in the database, and I'll just click on Sam Smith to give us a quick overview. At the top of the screen, you'll see the personal photo and the ability to organize them by A, B, C, or D, what type of contact they are, some basic information, phone numbers and emails can be up there. The location of where this person is, as well as the ability to quickly send Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, emails, or SMS text messages, as well as the ability to link a contact to a notebook of Evernote. On the main screen, you have the radar. It shows you just a quick overview of what notes or email information that has come in recently. On the right-hand side, all the activities that you either need to do that are past due or that you need to do. If they're in red, they're past due and you need to complete them. On the tab for contacts, this is the basic information, the home, work, and additional property information for any person that's in the database. Again, you have mapping for each of the different locations so you can quickly see those maps, as well as connections. So for any person that's in your database, you can track their Facebook, their Twitter, LinkedIn, any kind of blogs or RSS feeds, their Pinterest account, maybe their YouTube link or Google Plus, as well as an enhanced Google Map link. Also, each of the contacts can have personal data. Now, the way we set up the contacts in the database, they are individual contacts. If a husband and wife are in your database, you actually have two records. The neat thing about that is whenever you synchronize to your phone through Google, we do have Google Sync, it allows you to have a single entity on your phone for each person. So each person has their own phone numbers, their own websites, their own emails, all that's in there. But what we do is we tie them together so that those two records can be linked to each other. So if you need to get to Mary Smith, in this case, Mary is the spouse of Sam, you can just quickly click on Mary Smith and it'll take you to her record. And whenever you're dealing with mail merge information, there's a greeting and a mailing name field. So whenever you send out these emails or you want to print labels, this information is what can be printed, and it would exclude the secondary contact so that you would only print one record even though there are two in the database. So it's a really fantastic way of dealing with individual records but being able to treat them as one. Each contact in the database has a birthday, tells when the last purchase anniversary is for their last home. There's an area for the kids' names. You can put all the different kids' names, and as many kids' names as you like can be put in. Under the source details, you have the ability to select who they are referred by and when they were referred, as well as the source type. If you can have a drop-down list here of whether it came from a newspaper or a past client or whatever, as well as the URL where it came from. You can also track two personal pieces of information that a lot of people like to know is, when did I call them last and when did I make my last personal visit? So dates can be put in there, and then you can calculate when the next time you need to visit them based off of that last visit date, as well as a individual field that allows you to put in a client ID of your own, so that if you like to print labels or whatever for folders and be able to isolate them by some code that you've come up with, you can put that information in there. All that information is in one area of the tab called Contact. We also have tabs in here for properties, keeping track of which properties this person owns, what transactions are currently going on with each of those properties, as well as keeping track of any files. You may have different types of files that are assigned to the person or even to the property or transaction. Those can be assigned as well. Any calendar items or activities can be assigned, and you can look at those in either a day view, week view, or month view. You can view your entire list over here on the left side, clicking on the view all, be able to see what information is in there. Now, I've only got 21 names in this list, but if there's thousands, you can see them. From here, you're also able to filter out by owner. So if whoever the record owner is, you can say, well, show me only those records that belong to me if you share a database with other people, as well as the ability to mark all the records or mark individual records that you like. You can add notes to them, delete them. If you've worked with a large farming area and you want to delete, re-add them in, you can mass delete if you like, as well as the ability to do mass emails. We can send out emails to everybody. And we do interface with Google, so you can export these records, the marked records, to a Google spreadsheet and then be able to use those for printing labels, printing cards, whatever, through Google, as well as Avery. There's a really cool website for being able to bring in information to the Avery website. Or if you just want to export it to a CSV, that's possible as well, and then use it for however you like. So the basic types of contact data collection are all in here. One section of Realvolve. The other sections deal with properties. In this section, we have again a radar area that allows us to see what notes and correspondence, emails, things that have come in that are pertinent to this property. See the basic information at the top as well as the activities, just like you could on the contact. But also we have a listing tab, and this is where we keep track of what basic listing information there is on this property, as far as the details, square footage, bedrooms, bathrooms, all the standard things that you would see within a property, a listing itself, as well as some of the additional highlights and all the people that are involved within that transaction. Who's the seller? Who's the selling agent? The attorneys? There might be a tenants or relocation specialist. There's lots of people that can be involved within a listing, and it gives you the ability to quickly grab information from contacts on the left-hand side, drag them to the right, so you've got click and drag capabilities, which is really nice. And this is really key and instrumental whenever dealing with workflows, and we'll get into workflows in just a few seconds. As far as marketing, what types of information do you need about this property for marketing? Where am I storing it in the website? What's its URL, its virtual tour URL? The blog or Pinterest or my YouTube channels. All this information, as well as certain taglines, you can put in multiple lines of information in these to be able to include the narratives in flyers or emails, stuff like that, that go out, which is really cool. Again, used within the workflows and in email templates. We also have the ability to track anytime you want to send a note to your seller about what has transpired within the listing. You can include that just by clicking on the plus. We can add additional items to the list as far as what type of activity, when did it happen, and what kind of message you want to send. That information is then listed here. We have, which is really cool, the ability to add this seller report request as part of the activities that you add to a workflow. Can have checklist, and one of the checklist items can be a seller report. Any kind of showing information, what type of codes that you would need for showing the property, directions, showing instructions, all that is there, as well as, again, the files, listing documents, all those can be uploaded to the system and stored, so you have instant access to that information. You can also set up the system so that each property that you have is linked to an Evernote. So if I come here and I want to say I want to create a new Evernote, it'll name it by the address that it is, and I say attach. So now anytime I put a note into the radar, if I put information into the system, it can be instantly linked to your Evernote notebook that's connected. And those notebooks can then be shared to your sellers, also your buyers, if you want to do this on a transaction. So anybody that needs access to that information can have instant access to it as you put it into it. The calendar, being able to see anything dealing with this property, either by month, week, or day, or if you just want to see them in a list. Same type of thing. So as we go through this listing, there might be some things that we need to do. Say I want to verify some primary data. We can come in here, and you'll notice that we've added the ability to add fields into checklists. So I want to make sure, did I enter the listing date? And Yes, I did enter the listing date, and this is the correct listing date. You could use it as a verification to make sure it's correct. If there is no date in there, you can enter it right here. You can enter this as a data entry point for maybe an assistant that would allow you to not necessarily have to go into each individual field within the listing and fill it in, but just a checklist. Make sure these certain fields are filled in. Did I enter the expiration date? Did I put in the listing price? Do I have the correct seller? All this information can be entered right here in the checklist. You can also have static information. Did I add this to the MLS? Yes, I did. You'll notice that the checklist of this item is not complete until all checklist items are done. Now, if for some reason you've got a checklist item that does not qualify, you can click on it one extra time and it will mark it out as opposed to being marked as completed. It can mark it as being not needed and it will still consider it as being complete as far as the activity itself. So this is a real cool way of making sure that all the things that you need to do for a particular action is complete in order for it to be considered complete. Once I close that, then it's marked off and moved down into the completed area. Likewise, if there's any kind of post-listing activity that maybe I need to do, put the sign in the yard, lockbox on the door, I've completed those. Or if I want to go through and I want to send a thank you email. In order to complete this, I need to send the email. I'm going to run this. Now, it gives you the ability to send it immediately to the buyer or the seller or whoever this email is supposed to go to, and it can go to any of the party members that are associated to this property. Or you have the ability to edit the message, see information on here. If you need to change, make any kind of changes, you can do that. You can also preview the message to make sure that it's going to say everything that you want to say. Once you've got that, then you can click on send the message, and then it goes ahead and sends that message for you and then marks that activity as complete. So some really cool capabilities that are built into the system to be able to organize you, make sure that you work effectively, efficiently, and quickly, especially for those checkbox items. Any activity can have an unlimited number of checklist items as well as many different actions that you may want. The calendar would give you a full month, week, day view of everything that you've got in your system, not just a particular person or a particular property or transaction, but everything that's in your calendar. So that's an overview of the first three items. The transactions is basically the same type of thing as the properties. It gives you the ability to see all the transactional information, important dates, different fields, as well as the property that's associated with that transaction. And then all the people that are involved, who's the buyer, the seller. Again, you can assign files, calendar, and activities to the transaction, as well as keeping track of the commission information. There's an entire commission piece here to allow you to quickly pull up and keep track of commission information. Any documents that are sent to you by email, they can all show up in a documents area. You can quickly get access to them without having to search too hard for them. Anytime that you want to do a search by certain tag fields, you may have your newsletter people, you may have your church group, you can pull up based off of a tag any contact within your database or any property. Everybody can be assigned tags, and these tags allow you to quickly pull them up by the tag name. So say I want to put Sam Smith on my newsletter list, and there's the tag. I can assign as many different tags as I want. What happens then is anytime that I go into my tags area and I want to see everybody that's on my newsletter list, it would quickly pull up that list. I can then do out emails, exporting to Google, or even to a CSV file if I want to use them for other purposes. In the list view, I also have the ability to see all the activities that are assigned to me in one specific area. I can do a search by the status, whether I want to pull up just those that are complete or incomplete, how I want to order them by due date or priority or recently added. I can also pull up who is it assigned to, whether it's me or my assistant, and given a date range if I like, or by color. If I want to see all activities in one shot, I can do that, as well as marking all the records, completing them, deleting them. Lots of different capabilities are there. the workflow is really the key element to Realvolve. And the most powerful part, they are similar to action plans that you might find in Top Producer or Agent Office, some of the other softwares that are out there. But workflows go a whole lot broader and deeper than an action plan. One of the action plans I have here is a new listing. If I click on new listing, I can just quickly see all the activities that are in here. There are individual activities. Each activity has the ability to be set up so that they are assigned to anybody that is in your user list. You can pick which parties that are involved with that, whether it's the buyer, the seller, all the different party members that might be involved within a given activity. If you're sending out emails or whatever, you want to know who do I need to send the email to, and that's in there. The ability to schedule this based off of a calculated date or a computed date. In this case, I want to do 0 days after the listing date. I want to make sure that I've completed all my post-listing activity. And the post-listing activity is, did I put the sign in the yard and did I put the lockbox on the door? Those were the two activities that we had checked off earlier. And this is how you set up those activities. Once you get all of your activities set up, then you can apply this workflow to a new listing and it will remind you each day of the things that need to be done. Now, in addition to being able to do checklists, we show here the ability to do checklists with those fields. We wanted to verify the listing date, the expiration date, the listing price, and the seller. I showed that earlier, as well as some static ones which we just typed in. So setting up all the activities is probably the most difficult part until you understand it. Once you understand it, it's very easy. It's just a method for putting in information that you're going to use over and over again. Same type of thing for templates. Templates are used as templates for email. You can set them for email, for Facebook messages, for LinkedIn messages, Twitter, or even SMS text messages. We have built-in capability to automatically text out to your buyers, your sellers, or other people within your system. Setting up a template is the best way of setting up emails that are going to be going out, and you can use merge fields in any of these so that it fills it in from the fields within the database. So if, for instance, I wanted to say thank you for listing, I'm going to come over here to this one. We just said thank you for listing. I want to send this thank you for listing and trusting your property. Now, I could leave it like that if I wanted to, but if I want to include a merge field, I can come over here and type in a double bracket, so bracket, bracket, and then I can start typing in a field content like address. So as I type in address, I can see in the list that I have my property street address, and I can pick that, and it puts that in as a merge field. Once I've got that information in there, I've got it how I want it to look, I can come down here to the bottom and click on save, so that anytime I send this information, it goes ahead and fills in all the merge fields and makes it very personal, even though it is a templated email. So that's the basics of Realvolve. There's also a setup area so that you can go in and do settings and set up some of the additional features within Realvolve. We're not going to cover that. That's really after you've really got into this. But if you've got any questions, please email us, support@realvolve.com. We'd be happy to answer whatever questions you've got, and hope that you are as excited as we are about what Realvolve can do. And we're only scratching the surface as to what's to come, because we've got a lot more planned. There's some really exciting things dealing with email coming up, and actually even the dashboard capabilities to be able to do some additional things within the dashboard. So look for more things to come, and if you don't see quite what you're looking for right now, please be sure to check back with us in a month or two, and you may see some really cool stuff. Have a great day. Enjoy your week.